fit to be.
See what happens when I have a mic? Things begin to happen, so you just watch out. These guys are really going to put on a performance tonight. So, hey, thank you all for coming. This is a special privilege to have these guys show up. You guys all know where they're from. They flew in today, not yesterday or last week. They flew in today from Pacific Northwest Oregon. That's about as far away as you can get in the United States. It is a special honor and a privilege to be able to introduce these guys. They are, I had some guy come up to me tonight when I came in and says, man, I'm surprised that this isn't packed out because this is the best group that you guys have this year. So we are excited. So probably what you should do is you should get out your phones and text your friends and tell them to get over here real quick. Or if you can't text, then you can call. Or if you don't know how to text or not. So yeah, bring them in. So I just want to make one announcement. Is the March 2nd, we have a new group coming in. It's a third fret harmony group. They'll be here on March 2nd. And also, just a reminder, there's that little blue house around the corner there if you need to use it. I think you all know what I'm talking about. Just want to remind you, don't go that way and think you're going to find something that way. It's over that way. So thank you so much for coming. Let's give these guys a great, warm welcome.
Get to rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We'll sing and shout the victory.
Somewhere listening for my name. much, and good evening, everyone. You heard a little bit of the story, and I won't go into a lot of detail, but it's a little bit hard to know where to start, because 2 days ago, we were sitting in a snowstorm in Oregon, and where are we at now? Sarasota, yeah. Yesterday, we were in Portland, Oregon, Seattle, Washington, and then stretching through the middle of the night, Atlanta, Georgia, and then, of course, here in Sarasota, and let's see, Craig, y'all went through Newark, New Jersey, didn't you? And where were you at, Craig? You were at Newark, too. So anyway, we've been all over the country. But hour and a half, on a plane, you don't get all that much sleep when you fly all night long. It was not our intention. We were to be here yesterday, and we'd had this morning to set up equipment and run through some practices and do whatever we needed, but didn't happen that way. We get what life deals with us, and the instruments, they travel 3,000 miles, 6 miles up, and sometimes funny things happen to them, and we're a little bleary-eyed and bedraggled, so I hope you make it through, but we had plans quite different than that, but had the second biggest snowstorm ever to hit Portland, Oregon Airport. We have very little snow in Portland. We're an hour from the Pacific Ocean, get the moderating breezes blowing in. Don't have a lot of cold, freezing weather. Just don't. And it hit the night that we needed to fly to Sarasota, Florida. So anyway, we're here. We're happy to be here. This is our fourth year of being here and at Berkey Square, and first time at Ed's, but at Palm Grove Church, Sarasota Community Church, and I'll tell you a little bit more about those a bit later. So by way of introduction, some of you know our folks and have seen them before, or have some personal friends that come to Florida for the winter, and you know those people, but I'll go through it for the rest of you. On the far end, we have Gary Cook. It is Gary's first time to Sarasota, Florida. We had a different tenor singer, I guess pre-COVID was our last year. We canceled one of the COVID years, but 2018, I think, was our, or 19 was our last year here. So Gary's been with us. He's in his second year now, sings a high tenor. Gary was the church worship team, music leader for 25 years or so. So he brings an awful lot to us vocally. You'll really enjoy him singing the high tenor parts. He farms just outside of Albany, Oregon. I know some of you know where Albany is. Next to him, we have Craig Ulrich. And Craig and is owner of a construction company. They build homes and some commercial buildings. Craig's been playing right from the start with us. We're about 13 years playing together and pretty much have the original group with the exception of the tenor singer. Craig, of course, plays lead guitar, sings lead baritone, and he has the lead out in quite a few songs we do. We have Larry Knox next to him. Some of you heard of the six Knox brothers that toured singing the gospel for 50 years. Larry's dad, Marion, was the oldest of those six Knox brothers. Larry's been with us for 12 of the 13 years or so. He sings lead, baritone, tenor, anything else we ask him to. He's the young kid of the group. You haven't even hit 60 yet, have you? You will this year? Yeah, I think he's going to turn 60 this year. Oh, he's the baby of the group. You know, the rest of us been around a lot longer than that. Going to the back row, we have Jerry Stutzman, plays the five-string banjo and harmonica. You'll enjoy his instrumentals on some of those. He lives in Salem, Oregon, not too far from me. Next to him, we have Gene Stutzman, who lives in Albany, Oregon also. Gene's been playing mandolin for 45 or 50 years, that long, probably. And but Gene is the oldest one in the group. Doesn't really look like it. He's retired now, but in his last couple of years, he came back to the retirement village that's there in Albany. And early on, he had been a CEO there, but he came back in a chief operating officer role and some other jobs. And it just struck him, these elderly people that were here in this retirement village. But it didn't take him very long to realize most of them had been high school classmates of his. So he got acquainted with him after that a little bit more. Tice Pedersen plays bass guitar, also lives in Albany, Oregon. And my name's Will Barnhart, and I sing bass in group and do the emceeing. All of these guys are native Oregonians, grew up, were raised in Oregon. And as some of you know, I grew up in Shenandoah Valley, Virginia, Augusta County, Virginia. I know there's a few of you here, and we'll see them throughout the weekend, that are from that area and knew my parents or me, or I went to school with them in Harrisonburg or something. But I married an Oregon girl, and she won out, and we moved to Oregon in 1981, and I've been there ever since. So anyway, that's the group. We came to sing tonight, so we're going to get back to singing.
From the morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on that celestial shore. I'll fly away. Years ago when I was just a boy in the Oklahoma hills, we didn't have a church in which to pray. So the people got together and they built one of their own, just a shelter made of holes at the roof of hay. Well, it wasn't just the Baptist or the Church of the Nazarene, but people of all faiths came there to pray. And it didn't make no difference in color or the kind, and lots of folks would sing till the break of day. And they called it a fresh army. You could hear people singing far away. Just praise the Lord and shout in victory. I can still hear them singing today.
Thank you.
through this land, this pilgrim land.
Protect me by thy
saving power.
Salvation's plan. Oh, the grace of
He sings this best loved old hymn, "He Hideth My Soul."
Covers me there with his hand. He
working on a new CD. We have six of them I'll talk about later, but we're starting a seventh one, and we kind of came across this song and said that'd be good to put on new CD, so we kind of made that one our feature song and built from there, but we really took a liking to it, and we're going to do it for you tonight and see if you like it as well as we do.
Jesus has a table spread where the saints of God are fed. He invites his chosen people, come and dine. With his manna he doth feed and supplies our every need. Oh, tis sweet to sup with Jesus all the time. Come and dine, the master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. He who fed the multitude turned the water into wine. To the hungry calleth now, come and dine. Soon the Lamb will take his bride to be ever at his side. All the hosts of heaven will assemble be. Oh, we'll be a glorious sight, all the saints and spotless white, and with Jesus we will feast eternally. Come and dine, the master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. He who fed the multitude turned the water into wine. To the hungry calleth now, come and dine. Come and dine, the master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. He who fed the multitude turned the water into wine. To the hungry calleth now, come and dine. He who fed the multitude turned the water into wine. To the hungry calleth now, come and dine.
Barry, I'll turn to you for a bit.
Okay, and I'm going to stay over here, that way there's no interference. Plus you guys don't really need to look at me that way, but now is the time that you can, you've been blessed by this great group, and so now is an opportunity for you to bless them and to give back to them. And like I said, I don't mean to, you know, make it sound like, you know, but we like to really bless them since they came that far. That's a long way, you know, so, and they had a hard time getting here. It wasn't just like an easy flight over, so. Ask a blessing for it, and then we'll have an offering. Father, we just thank you so much for this opportunity that we can be here, we can sing praises to your name, and just be blessed by this group, this Bethel Mountain Band coming down all the way from Oregon. Lord, I just pray that as we bless them, as they have blessed us, we will bless them with an offering, Father, and we just thank you for all that you've done for us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Somebody want to come up and say some jokes?
Yeah.
I guess they take up the offering before it gets dark so you can see how much you're putting in or where to reach for it. But anyway, thank you very much. We're going to catch a couple more songs now, and then we'll change the tune a little bit of what we're doing. But there's this one song that we like to do. We've done it at a lot of concerts. Everybody that follows us around knows that we love the old-timey gospel songs, the ones people haven't heard for a long time, songs that aren't sung in churches nowadays. We sang this one that we're just getting ready to do at a retirement home or nursing home here a couple years back. A lady came up and says, you know, I haven't heard that song since 1950. Well, that kind of statement brings joy to our hearts, because we want to keep those kind of songs alive. So here's one of those songs. Some of you may remember it or heard it, or maybe all of you, but it's what we used to know as a slow funeral song. And we sped it up and add our instruments to it a little bit. And our wives just absolutely didn't like it. And they said, don't put that song in any of your CDs. But if you come up to the table after, it's on our number 2 CD right up here. And you can hear it there if you like it well enough the way we do it right now. So give a listen.
We are going down the valley one by one, with our faces toward the setting of the sun. Down the valley where the mournful cypress grows, where the stream of death and silence onward flows. We are going down the valley,
yes, we're
going down the valley.
We are going
toward the setting of the sun. We are going.
Ed Detweiler is our host here. Ed, would you stand up for me a minute and turn around and face the crowd? Look at this. He's got to be our number one fan. Look at that shirt he's got on there. Thank you, Ed. I appreciate you making the place available here. Churches, you know what a cappella is. But to us, a cappella means to these guys, we don't need you. You know? We just sing. So, anyway, here's our a cappella number.
I sing the mighty power of God that made the mountains rise, that spread the flowing seas abroad and built the lofty skies. I sing the wisdom that ordained the sun to rule the day. The moon shines full at his command, and all the stars obey. I sing the goodness of the Lord that filled the earth with food. He formed the creatures with his word, and then pronounced them good. Lord, how thy wonders are displayed where'er I turn my eye. If I survey the ground I tread, or gaze upon the sky, There's not a plant or flower below but makes thy glories known. And clouds arise and tempests blow by order from thy throne. While all that borrows life from thee is ever in thy care, and everywhere that man can be, thou God art present there. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Okay, we'll give the instrumentalists a chance to show that they don't need us and they can still produce good music. So listen to this instrumental. Singing. There's another piece or two that I want to call attention to with that group. You know, as I was saying, so 11 of us, counting some spouses, flew in this morning and last night. Of course, would have been 13. Jean and Judy Stutzman are here for the winter, so they were already here, but the rest of us had to come in. We were on three different flights, and all three got canceled. Part of what messed it up, but we did have a pretty important piece of our group that was here already besides Gene and Judy, and that was our sound people. Chris and Irma Nisley from Loyola, Pennsylvania, they got here on Monday, was it Chris, the 20th anyway, they got here, so they didn't have to worry about a snowstorm or anything else, so they'd have been here even if we didn't make it, but they followed us around. We did a tour of Virginia, Pennsylvania back in October, November, and they went to every one of those 10 or 11 concerts there, and do a great job for us. We really appreciate them, Chris and Irma Nisley. Would you give them a hand, please, for their help here? We have hauled our equipment to Florida before and trucked it in and such like, but this is all their equipment here, and works out really, really good for us not to have to bring it along. So thank you all very much. We're going to branch out a little bit now and do what we call our country folksy songs. We do mostly gospel and old hymns. That's just what we do. But we have a couple that we do for outdoor festivals and such. And this song was introduced by John Denver to the popular in country crowds going on 52 years ago. Larry doesn't remember it, of course, but the rest of us do. But it's a song that it just seems to be one the crowds love, and we like singing it. And it's been said that this is the most recognized song the world over. If you mention this song or someone sings it, more people in the world know this song than anything else of this that genre of song. So anyway, we're going to let you have tonight our version of Country Roads.
He said I didn't remember it, but I do. I did. They always hassle me because I first heard it on the school bus.
First grade, maybe.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, blowing like a breeze. Country roads take me home to the place.
Oh,
favorite Statler Brothers song.
She was standing in the crowd, all alone and looking pretty, listening to the music that we played. She walked up and whispered, "I lean down and listen to the request that she made."
"Do you know you are my sunshine?" she asked so sweet and tenderly. Border to border and ocean to ocean, I still look for her every place. Chasing the sunshine each and every night, I'm searching every crack for her face. She was gone just as quick as a song that she asked for, taking the sunshine away. Just what I'm gonna say.
Do you know you are my sunshine? Do you know what your smile did for me?
Do you know you are my sunshine? And it looks like you're always gonna be.
Do you know
you are my sunshine?
Yes, so sweet and tenderly.
Do you know
you are my sunshine?
And would you do it one more time for me?
Do you know
you are my sunshine?
Each step I take,
I know that He will guide me to higher ground He ever leads me on. Until someday the last step will be taken, each step by day just leads me closer home. Each step by day just leads me closer home.
Holding me. goodbye. I'm gonna see my Savior standing at the door. Then I'll hear him say, you're welcome. All your cares are left behind. And I won't have to worry anymore.
Thank you. be where the soul of man never met, where I will spend eternity, where the soul of man never dies. No sad farewell, no tears of tear, where all this be satisfied, and the soul of
songs to do to wrap up a program for the evening. I want to tell you about some other opportunities to come hear us again this weekend if you liked our music. If you didn't like it, you probably should have left about 20 minutes ago. So we are going to be at the Sarasota Community Church, which a lot of us many years ago knew as the Bella Vista Mennonite Church. I'm sure you all know we've been there before when we've been on tour here. We will be there tomorrow night, that's Saturday night, at 6:30 now, to give a program. And we will be doing some different songs. You'll hear some repeats. We tried to mix them up a little bit so you'll think it's a different program. But we have some others that you will hear. And then Sunday night, we'll be at Palm Grove Mennonite Church at 6 o'clock again. Same as tonight, 6 o'clock at Palm Grove Mennonite. It will be out in the gymnasium, not the church sanctuary. And again, some ones there, a little different because it's a Sunday night church service. So you'll hear a few different ones, more of the hymns and gospel ones. And then to wrap up what we're doing here in Sarasota, Monday night at Berkey Square, our fourth time at Berkey Square, and we will be there at 6 p.m. also to finish up. And then we fly back to Oregon on Tuesday morning. And I don't think there's any snowstorms here that will keep us from doing that. So anyway, hopefully we get home then. But that's what it is. I'm sure you've seen that on posters around or handouts that maybe Ed gave you. Tomorrow night, 6:30, Sarasota Community Church. Sunday night, Palm Grove Mennonite Church at 6 p.m. And Monday night, over at Berkey Square at 6 p.m. also. I want to say we do have CDs. As I mentioned earlier, they're on the table back here. We have six of them out. We've been here enough other years. I know a lot of you have some of the CDs, but if you don't have them all, have a look at them. Our spouses, most of them are here with us, and we'll all be there to help you if you want to take our music home with you. Our prayer really has been that you are blessed and inspired by our music, and that the gospel of Christ is carried through the message of our songs. We don't do a lot of talking or preaching in between songs. Bill Gaither once said, if you got to preach a sermon between each song, then don't bother singing the song. Well, we kind of like to let the song do the teaching, but we really want to make sure that you hear through the songs the salvation plan. Amen. We sing a lot of songs about heaven. It's because we know we're going there, and we want to make sure you do too. So hopefully you've been blessed and inspired by the songs that we've sung tonight, or maybe heard some that you haven't heard for quite some time, and ones that you enjoy or that we enjoy. We do have a Facebook page. A bunch of you, I know, are Facebook friends already. If you want to keep up with us or see more pictures of the group, like us on our Facebook page as well. And we're still working on our website. We had to build a new one because we had trouble with the old one, and we've got one. If you look it up, you'll see some things on there. We're still working on that one. But just want to say thank you for coming out tonight. For joining us here. It has been an absolutely beautiful evening. It's what I call room temperature. You know, this just feels like it couldn't be more perfect. So thank you all for coming and enjoying the music and sharing this beautiful evening with us. We're very, very happy that we made it here and are back with you all in Sarasota again tonight. So we'll wrap it up with our final couple of numbers.
Shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal, bright and fair. When the saved earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder,
when the roll is called up yonder,
I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder,
when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
From the dawn to setting sun, let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. And when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Yonder I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
What a time we will have when we cross the misty foam. What a time when the saints of all ages are gathered home. What a time we will have over there. What a time we will have when we reach that far land. What a time we will have over there. When the singers shall join in that heavenly band. What a time we will have over there. Young and old, green and color, will all be as one, and amazing grace will be heard everywhere. What a time we will have when we see Jesus Christ. What a time we will have over there. What a time we will have when
You've got one more.
One more.
One more.
Two more.
Three more. They're not listening.
It ain't midnight yet.
More.
I guess Renee's will show up.
How are you doing? Nice to see you. I heard you guys.